Hello students, today we will be discussing some numerical problems based on work, power and energy. So starting with our first problem, a force of 20 Newton displaces an object through 10 centimeter and does 1 joule work in this process. So we have to find the angle between force and displacement. Now, here in this question, we are given that a force of 20 Newton is applied, due to which a displacement of 10 centimeter is there. Now, in this question, the displacement is given in centimeter, that is the CGS system. So, it has to be converted into meter. So, 10 over 100, that is equal to 0.1 meter is a distance. Now, we know that the work is F S cos theta. This is a work done. Now, we know that 1 joule of work is done on application of 20 Newton of force, which causes a displacement of 0.1 meter. Into cos of theta. Theta is angle between force and displacement. That has to be calculated. So that will be equal to 1 equal to 2 cos of theta. That is 1 by 2 is equal to cos theta. Now it means that we have to evaluate when the value of cos theta is half. The value of cos theta is half at theta equals to 60 degree. Hence, the angle between the force and displacement is of 60 degree. Let us discuss next question. Two bodies of masses 1 kg and 4 kg have equal kinetic energies. Find the ratio of momentum. Now we are given the masses of the two bodies and it is said that they have equal kinetic energies. We have to evaluate the ratio of their momentum. We know that M1 be a mass of first body, that is 1 kg. M2 be a mass of second body, that is 4 kg. And both have equal kinetic energies. So K1, that is kinetic energy of first body, is equal to K2, that is kinetic energy of a second body. We know that the relation between kinetic energy and momentum is kinetic energy is equal to P square over twice of M. So according to the given problem, we can state that P1 is a momentum associated with M1. So P1 square is equal to twice of M1, that is equal to P2 square. P2 is a momentum associated with second body upon twice of M2. Now substituting the values, we will be getting P1 by P2 is equal to under root of M1 by M2. Now we know the value of M1 and M2, that is 1 M1 and M2 is 4. Hence, the ratio is 1 over 2. So, the momentum will be 1 is to 2. Now, let us discuss another question. The value of G on moon is 1 by 6. The value of G on Earth. A man can jump 1.5 meter high on the earth. Calculate how high he can jump on moon. Now, in this question, we are given that g on moon, that is acceleration due to gravity, small g on moon is equal to 1/6 of g on earth. Now it is said that on earth, height attained by a person, that is h, is 1.5 meter. Now let us consider that on moon, height attained by men, that let it be h1, be x meter. So work which is done by a person to jump either on earth or on moon will be equal. So work on earth to jump is equal to work on moon to jump. That must be equal. So we know that the work done on earth by a man to jump to a height of 1.5 meter is his mass into acceleration due to gravity into h, that is on earth is 1.5 meter. That is equal to work done by a person on earth. So that will be equal to mass of a man into g, that is gravity on moon, into h, that we have to calculate. Sorry, that is x. So on equating both the things, we will be getting g into 1.5, substituting gm, that is ge by 6, into x. Now we know that both the g's are equal because they are taken on the earth. So 1.5 into 6 is the value of x, that is 9 meter. So if that man jumps on moon, he will be jumping to a height of 9 meter. Okay, thank you students.